I don't know. I can press. I keep. Oh, here we go. Here we go. They're cracking. All right. Imprint. Hello, guys. Zul'jin here, and welcome back to another episode of Ark Survival Evolved, guys. I hope you all are having a terrific day. Thank you all so much for all the support on the Ark series. As always, guys, if you do enjoy the videos, make sure to give me some dap on that like button to show you support for my channel, and you can subscribe for more daily videos. I'm on my way back to the barn from a little run getting some polymer. Well, not polymer, but obsidian to make some polymer. There's a couple things I want to make today because I'd like to get into making a breeding chamber. Saw a couple of my fellow Pooping Evolved members doing some breeding chamber stuff. And since I've gotten... since I've gotten a couple of breeding chambers set up, I would like to put some air conditioners in one for some actual, some incubation. As well. Now, I think that's going to be important. All the feedback on the hay bales and stuff, I think you guys really, really liked, and I'm glad y'all liked the Plessy episode as well. The Plessyosaur was such a debacle, and it was kind of an opportunity thing. Like I said at the beginning of the video, we were going for a Mosasaur because I wanted to eventually do a water base, and I was going to get one just to level it up and stuff like that. But the Plessy is going to work just fine for what I want to do for now, and in turn, start looking for more Mosasaurs a little bit later on. So that's going to be something that comes in the future. Right now, we're still going to focus on the task at hand. Naturally, when we have collab opportunities, like when people feel like getting together and doing stuff, we always try to do something that's not so personal. Although, every once in a while, helping someone in their base or having somebody help with my base is pretty cool too. So I'm glad you guys like the mix. At any rate, Archangel's got some stuff. So let's get to the fabricator and start making some stuff. Now, mind the noise that it's going to make here, but I think we have just about everything that we need for what we want. The only thing that I wasn't sure about is I do want to make a canteen, first of all, because last time when I died, I did lose my my water jar, and I think it's time to go for an upgrade. So let's see. If we go to miscellaneous canteen, I can make one right away. Does it take any polymer? It takes 10. That's gonna kind of hurt. Okay, let's make some more polymer. I'm pretty sure I have enough to do everything here. What about my cementing paste? I have 74. Yeah, we should be able to make plenty. So let's turn it on, go to composites, and what am I missing? The obsidian that, of course, old Archangel has. I have plenty, actually. Well, I don't know about plenty, but I do have quite a bit. All right, make some composites. I can make 37. I'm gonna go ahead and do it, y'all. I'm just gonna make a ton. Well, not all of them. Let's see. Let's make 20. Okay, so that's gonna be plenty to go. And the next thing that we'll queue up is gonna be the canteen. And like I said, this is just for me. All right, so the canteen's queued up. Now, let me get away from this. For the rest of it, what I'd like to do for the breeding chamber is XB did one the other day, and I think I saw a couple of other people do it. And basically, and what y'all have been telling me in the comments is if I have like 5 or 6 air conditioners in one spot, it really does a good thing for, I guess you could say, like the temperature. So the insulation is what changes. I was kind of confused because when you look at this, when you hold H and you see the temperature and stuff, that doesn't change. What does change is the insulation amount. So right now I have my hyperthermal insulation is 99, okay? And my hyperthermal insulation is 219. If we were to take this off, that changes immediately. An air conditioner kind of does the same thing, but it does it for the ambient location. So eggs can pretty much hatch anywhere if you get the right temperature control. It gives both insulation values. So that's what we're going for. Okay, so now that we have the polymer and the canteen, let's take our canteen, by the way. Ah, it's going to be so nice. I also want to make another spyglass today, too. All right, since we got all of that, let's take a look at... Not that. Is it structures? Electric? Yes. And we need metal ingots for that. So, we're going to need... For like 5 of them, we're going to need like 400 metal ingots, which... I don't know how much of that we have. I do know we have some in the smithy. And I actually do have a little bit on... Archangel here to smelt. We have 20 there along with That was 20 raw, so that's really only 10 ingots. And it doesn't look like we have any metal whatsoever in the smithy except this 20. How about in the actual forge? Only 13 ingots. This is going to be a problem, guys. I'm going to have to smelt up a whole bunch of ingots before we do that. But I'm going to let this ride and actually go out to the other smith to get a bunch of that metal going. So all I need is a little bit of wood to get this going, and I'll work on some more metal, and then we'll be back for the air conditions, you guys. All right, you guys, I got my air conditions made, and I'm also running some wire. I took the wire all the way down there that was originally put in for my refrigerator at the front part of my barn, and I ran a little wire up here and ran one close to my pipe. Since this area is already kind of construction area, I figured it would be okay. Now all I need to do is put a junction box. Now, these two seams that you see on the wall right here that have come down, I thought about doing it to this one, but I think just the way the wire came out, I think it'll be a little bit nicer if I do the other one. Now, it's like five tiles below this crease. I'll show y'all what I mean. If I go into my barn, where the very corner starts, like where the roof starts to slope in, you can count 1, 2, 3, 4 below that. And I guess it's kind of hard to see here. Let me get to an area that y'all can see. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 below that, actually. So where that corner piece is, I have to go 5 below that in order for my wire to line up where the junction box is going to be, just so it's not so intrusive with the wiring that comes from the junction box. So if we count that, that's going to be, let's see if I can look at it here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Meaning that it's so hard to do this when when you're flying. 1, 2, 3, 4. I'm on the fourth one, so the fifth one will be like right there. Let me see here. I don't want to put it that about there, actually. I think that's right on the money. Yep, pretty much. Okay, so I have one wire too many. That's all right. I might need to work something there later, but the junction box should be good. So, as long as I put air conditioners in that vicinity, we should not have an issue. So let's go in the back here. I probably should get the twins out of there and move them into the other one. What am I doing? Let's see. Yeah, let's move the twins into the next breeding stall, just right here. And let's get Hot Wings. Ooh, Hot Wings, you laid an egg. Oh, are you, see, you don't have a saddle on you. Why? I need to make you a saddle, girl. Let's see here. Saddle. There we go. And I'll get Hot Wings out. Hot Wings just has a bunch of dyes on her right now. And I'll move all of these birds around too, once I start. And let's get the other one out here, just so I have some room to work. Now the feeding trough, I guess I'm going to have to move that too. Unfortunately, it kind of ends up at a weird place. Maybe I could put it on the side over there. Alright, so now that these are out, let me go ahead and close them up again. And here is where, the junction box comes out so good, man. It could be a little bit better, I suppose, but all right, let's start placing down these air conditioners. So, how do they sit? It looks like pretty straightforward here. Now, I'm not too sure if the corners work out the way they're supposed to, but we're going to try it. So right here we'll do, let's see, I'll probably put it as far into the corner as I can, like so. That should be good. All right, there's one air conditioner that's powered. It's probably sticking out the back a little bit. I didn't even think about it like that. Okay, and let's go with another one. And it's gonna be touching, or very, very close to touching. There we go. And we'll see if we could do another one. Touching, probably gonna be obstructed. No, it's not gonna be obstructed. That's awesome. Okay, so there's three right here. Now, I thought about going... I thought about doing like a little C shape, but if I can keep this just like that, I think it'll give me more room for eggs, and I should still be able to utilize the corner piece here. So let's move this into the same space, so to speak. Just like that. And one more. And that ought to give me a nice little corner for breeding. Okay. So, maybe I hope that didn't come out crooked. All right, so like I was telling you about the insulation, check this out. XB taught me this. If you look at my insulation right now, it's 451 out of and 515. Let's move a little bit closer. Now it's, where is it at? 564 and 628, okay? This is where I'm looking. Now let's look at it right here. 707 and 771. And right in the corner, it is 782 and 846. Now, I gotta tell you, that's some serious insulation for one area. I could put more, too, if I really needed to. But I guess the biggest question is, can we incubate an egg here? That's gonna be the big choice. Okay, so, let's see. Hot Wings, did you have any eggs on you? No fertilized eggs. I'm sure, I think the twins did, if I'm not mistaken. Let's see. Dawn. No. I bet you those fertilized eggs are downstairs. Let me grab them and then we'll test them, guys. All right, you guys. We got a couple of eggs. Punez was holding a couple of eggs and I actually put together Dusk and Hot Wings for a little bit of hot action. So I have three eggs to try out now. Another thing I did is install some light, because weather like this and stuff makes it pretty unpleasant to record in, and the omnidirectional light on this catwalk is kind of like a just a little standing lamp thing, and it isn't too harsh on the eyes, so we'll try that. So let's try out the eggs. Now, as you know, if we put down eggs over here at any weight, if we look at the temperature, it's like 94 degrees. An Argentavis egg is definitely going to show. Let's do fertilized Argentavis eggs, Hot Wings and Carrier Pigeon. This is the twins, and we'll do Hot Wings and Dusk. Okay, let's try this and just see. Now, it says right away that it is too hot. Okay, so we'll pick it up. That's fine. Now, let's try it right here. That's right on the side. It's a little bit out there. Drop item. Looks like it is incubating. Even right here. Okay. That's very good. Let's try one here. Drop item. It is incubating. So, I can put eggs all right here to drop. Very nice. They're all incubating at the same time. So, this is going to be from the Hot Wings and Dusk, which Hot Wings is a little low level, so just bear that in mind. We also have this, you know who this is from. This is the twins. I don't have their names in just because I don't know. I guess it laid the egg before they were actually named. So we'll just have to remember that. And if we look here, you'll see that the fertilized Argentavis egg is from Hot Wings and Carrier Pigeon. Now, the incubation process is quite a little bit long the ways, but there's a couple things I want to try here. First of all, I want to start doing breeding to where we can find out what stats are what. And in order to do that, you kind of have to keep track of it. Now, BTC and I were talking today, and he said something about you have to really take a screenshot of, you know, what the base stats are, because that's what it goes off of. And I thought about something. I was like, you know what you can do? You can probably make the base stats when you get a tame done and put it on a note. So, for instance, Archangel's been around since forever, like level 206. But what we could do, if we had just tamed Archangel, and we wanted to know its parental stats, that way we can keep track of it when we actually doing crossbreeding and stuff, what we can do is use this item. Let's just use it right here, right? Wait. Use item. And what I did is I wrote up the stats: health, stamina, oxygen, food, weight, melee, and movement. Even though movement doesn't really show here, right? And I guess I should add torpor too, but I did that on a notepad just so I can copy it and paste it right quick. So I'm just going to paste it here, and I'm actually going to add torpor to it too, just in case that's a stat that we have to measure, right? And you just put the stats in. So right now we have 5197 health. 5197.7. We have the stamina is 2400. Oxygen is 480. And food is 5800. Not that, not that that's a stat that we really, really pay attention to, but you get it. It might be something that we have to consider. For Fiomias, it's something to consider. How many stem bears can you use before they start starving and taking damage? Weight is 524.2. And, oh wait, did I run out of space here? What happened? What happened? Oh, I guess I took too long. That's something. Okay, well, you get the point. Let me just fill this in right quick. All right, guys. So basically, it doesn't give you a whole lot of time. What I would suggest, not all these stats are relevant either. Just make your own guide. But what I would suggest is halfway through it, just highlight it all just like you would in a text document and hold Control and press C to copy it. That way it's there. But now your note is there with all of the stats for this, and you can even call it whatever you want. Can we edit this again? That's a good question here. Let's put it back on. And no, you can't edit it. Once you make a note, you have to make a note. So we could have named this like, I don't know, we could have named it Archangel Stats. Archangel's, starting stats or whatever the case may be. And now, every time we go to Archangel, we can look and there'd be a note on it and it's going to say what the base stats are. So when we're trying to figure out what's what, you can always compare these instead of keeping documents outside of your computer, and it just makes it a little bit more immersive. Anyway, let's check on our eggs and see how they're doing. It looks as though the incubation process is about halfway. I think what I'm gonna do, guys, is just cut until this happens, and then we'll be able to look at some starting stats and feed some birds. I gotta get this food trough filled up right quick. We'll be right back. All right, guys, it's getting pretty much close to time here. I'm gonna grab a bunch of meat and put it on me. And I'm also gonna grab a bunch of meat and put it up in the feeding troughs. And we should have some hatching doing real, real soon here. I don't know, oh, here we go. They're cracking. All right, imprint. Nice, we'll keep you unnamed for now. And let's put some meat on you. Oh, very cool. Okay, so here we go. So this is his beginning stats. We're gonna have to put some stuff on you. Food, stamina, see, very nice. What level? Okay, so this is gonna be a 109. Uh-huh, here's another one. Let's go ahead and imprint. Have a little baby birds. Oh, and here's another one, white. Okay, imprint, very good. Okay, let's get some food on these guys, big time. Ah, very cool. No twins or triplets or anything, but that's pretty awesome. Let's see here. Oh yeah, you can hold some meat now. Aren't you getting big so fast? All right, let's start putting some into the actual feeding trough here. I could just press T now with this new method. This is pretty cool. All right. Also, I should be able to do that with these too. Let's go ahead and press T on stacks of meat. Uh-huh. It took about 10 or 11. And we should do the same thing with here. Uh-huh, all right, they're gonna grow up nice and big. And the incubation chamber works amazing. Okay, so they've been growing a little bit, and I have a little method of organization that I'd like to show you. Along with the little note setup that I have, I'm also going to name them. If I'm hatching multiples like this, I'm gonna name them after their parents because it gets kind of confusing. So we have baby hot carrier, so we have baby dust dawn, and we have baby hot dusk. So this is basically a hot wings and dusk kid. Now let's take a look at stats. I'm not going to mark them down on the notes yet, just because they aren't complete. But if you'll look, we have 2400 stamina, which is a good starting base stamina for this. 1682 health. I'm not going to concern myself with the oxygen. I'm going to concern myself with weight. The movement speed's not going to change, by the way, either. So I'm going to concern myself with weight, melee, health, and stamina. All right. So right now we're looking at 1680 and 2400. Let's compare those. 1680, 2400. 1680, 2400. Pretty good. 1856 and look at the stamina. So we have a higher health, stat, but a much lower stamina, like almost abysmal. Now, this was made by Hot Wings and Carrier Pigeon. Now, Carrier Pigeon was originally made for weight, but I'm not sure what its original stats were. So we got to start somewhere. We have to have a base somewhere. Since this breeding thing came along, we're just starting to pay attention to starting stats now. We would just tame a high-level Argentavis before and just pump its stats, but this is the way it's got to go now. So it's crazy, man, that it's that's the stats that big. Let's compare the second sets of stats. So we have the weight is 504 and melee is 231. Weight is 504, melee is 280. Okay, so far, the incest twins are a baller, man. And weight is 385 and melee is 231. So all we have right here, the only stat that shines anywhere here is health. Now, the health stat is really, really good on this. For a level 118, that's really not bad. Higher than 132 on Baby Dust Dawn and 109 on Baby Hot Dusk. So, we're looking at some good stat manipulation here. If we wanted a high health bird, we would definitely include Baby Hot Carrier in that recipe. You know, if we were looking for stamina, I think either one of these would be a good stamina candidate. But now, what would you want out of these two? You would probably want to make sure that I guess we have a base melee of 231 and this melee was 280. So far this is the better bird out of the three. Let's compare the off stats just in case. Oxygen 375, food 5800. Oxygen 600. Not that it can go underwater, but oxygen is very, very much a different stat. And food is 6,200. Torpor is 4,800. Torpor is 5,300. And torpor is 4,400 right here. So out of the three birds that we carried, the bird that supposedly might have had mutant genetics is the top bird. It's amazing. So there you go, ladies and gentlemen. Incest may be worth something. I'm not condoning it, by the way. I'm just making a joke. But anyway, Dusk and Dawn had a serious kid. It might be something out of purity. I'm not sure. I would love to know what you guys think about all this in the comments. But we're almost to the point to where these guys are safe. I'm going to go ahead and grab a little bit of food out the stall here. And I'm definitely going to need to grab some more food to put in the stall. It's no problem. Just a little trip on my bird and it should be fine. Let's put a couple stacks on each of them just to make sure they're good to go. All we need to do is get them to 10%, and after they're 10%, they'll start eating out of the trough, so it'll work out pretty good. And they already have enough food on them to carry them for a little while. So I'm not going to go through the entire maturation process tonight, guys. That's going to take too long, and it's getting a little late, but we will review everything in the next episode. Right before I go, I want to show y'all something really, really awesome. Got a couple presents while we were gone. XB dropped by with a ramshackle parasaur saddle. Not a parasaur saddle, what am I saying? A plesiosaur saddle, and that I'll put it right here. Some really, really good stats on it. 36.3 armor. She's already a boss. I took her out for a little while today and started to level her, and man, is she amazing. Next is this. Masion says, Merry Christmas. Check this out. Bam! Apprentice Slingshot, 131.4 damage, along with 65.4 max durability, and he made me one too. So we're gonna have to try these out. I've been practicing a little bit with the sniper rifle and the long rifle. You guys said that sway is very, very much improved with the sniper rifle like this, so let's just test it. I didn't give y'all a whole lot of shots last video, and I'm sorry about that. I don't want to kill another level 120 Dilla, okay? So I want to try the prone position and the crouching position right before we go, because I think it's relevant. All right, there's some crocodiles down there and stuff, some alligators. There's also some frogs, some birds. I think birds would probably be good to try. It's going to be harder to hit, but... So if we zoom in right here, let's just pick a target, shall we? This alligator is a pretty good target. Now, you see the sway? I'm not moving at all. All right, let's go ahead and hit C. And the sway is, wow, the sway is significantly reduced. Let's get to where we can actually pop this guy. he's going to get in just a bad place to where I can't even shoot him. Are you really that? Oh, man. All right, let's find something else to hunt. Every time I try to come shoot, there's always stuff in the bayou down there. And every time I try to come shoot my sniper rifle, it's trash. How about... there's this frog right here. Okay, let's get into prone, actually, and see what we can do here. There's hardly any sway here. Oh, game lagged. Did I hit him? There he is. Did I not sink him? And I'm out of ammo. I cannot believe. That's horrible shooting. And now he's coming back for some more. What level is this? Watch, it's a 120. And I don't have my other scope. What did... Hold on. I'm going to hit this guy. We're going to have to go down there to see what that's all about. Now I have to see what it is. Watch, it's a 120. If it's a 120 frog, I'm going to lose my mind. Because I'm a Cajun. I should be a good marksman. Supposedly, I hit him a few times. Is he down? Uh-huh. He sure is. What level is he? Level 12. Oh, man. Well, he's going to have to do for some good meat. Oh, and I got a... It's too bad I don't have my sniper rifle now. I could shoot him. Let's go ahead and kite this guy. Got to stay away from them his teeth, man. What level is this guy? 60. All right, I got to move. He's going to kill me. Yes, I know. I'm wearing cloth armor, and that's what they do. Hold on. Let's eat this piece of prime right quick to heal up some. How close was he to dead? Pretty close, actually. Let's try to get around him. Oh, I got a snake on me, too. Oh, that's going to knock me out. I got to go. No way. I'm not taking the chance. Not taking the chance. No way. Anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed the video. If y'all did, please don't forget to give us some dap on that like button to show your support for the series. And you can subscribe to the channel for more daily videos, guys. Thanks so much for watching. As always, this is Zul'jin signing off, and we'll see you next time.